executive session. When she does that, all of council and anybody else from administration that needs to be in the executive session will log off of this meeting. We'll receive a meeting invitation for the executive session. We'll log on to that meeting. All right. Everybody else will remain on the meeting. And at one point when the session is finished, we will rejoin.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
Quick question, Elizabeth, you want Jamar and Frank in?
Sure, yes.
Okay.
And Maria can join as well.
And Maria, okay.
Hi, Linda. This is Shane. I just want to make sure you're aware I'm on the call.
Yes, I see you, Shane. Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Okay, I'm going to go set that up.
Okay, and
I transferred the host to Ken.
Correct. I have the host. So as long as you just hit leave meeting, we should be sweet. It worked.
We need to let Jeremy know what the executive session is about then.
I think that was communicated in the chat.
Okay.
In the chat.
Okay, thank you. So we should all be leaving this now.
I believe we need to call the meeting to order first.
Okay, good.
Okay, so I don't know if we need Linda back on for that.
No, we don't.
Okay.
The link has something sent.
Did Donna join us? I want to make sure Donna's on the call.
No, I don't see her.
See Donna pop through?
I'll text her again.
Yep, because she's going to have to know what's going on here. So
Donna Reed, correct?
Yeah.
Donna Reed.
All right, hold on. There she is.
Okay.
She's currently muted.
Okay.
Is she muted?
Okay, suddenly I'm back in because I was hearing and seeing everyone, but I was trying to talk and nobody heard that.
We couldn't hear you. Donna, did you catch the gist of what's happening?
That we're going into executive session post-budget or pre-budget?
Pre-budget.
Pre-budget, okay.
Yeah. So we'll log off of this meeting.
Okay, just when I got on.
Okay, and then we'll log back in when ready. Everybody else is going to hold on this call.
We're logging back in a different link. Am I correct?
Yes. For the executive session.
Right.
So we're just.
If anybody gets
now.
If anybody gets lost, you can just log back on because people will still be here. So I'm going to go ahead and call this meeting to order. This committee of the whole, but it's a budget hearing this evening. November 10th. Welcome, everybody. We have the agenda as presented. There will be some modifications to this agenda. The budget review will begin with the auditor's report, and then will be followed by the charter board and ethics board. The law presentation will be presented at a later date. So just for anybody who is looking and watching with the agenda and the public, that is what is happening. And I'm going to turn over to the solicitor because she has, is Elizabeth still with us?
She's probably already clicked the link for the executive session.
Okay. Well, the solicitor has requested the need for an executive session. The members that have been requested for that are council and certain members of the administration. While we exit and enter into the portal for the executive session, we ask that anybody who wants to be part of the meeting here now stay on. And we'll be back.
Just a clarification, the executive session is regarding litigation.
Thank you, Marcia. Okay. Yes. All right. So at this time, anybody who wants to stay on this meeting portal may. Council and administration members who need to be part of the executive session, please log off and log on through the alternate link. We'll meet up. Thanks, everyone.
Down to the skeleton crew.
Hey, Frank. No, I'm trying, but let me see. Okay. Yes. Okay, let me do that. Yeah, that should work. Okay. All right. Let me do that. Thank you.
Okay, some of us made it back. I see Ken's still holding, Shane's holding, Chief Stout's holding. Thanks, everybody. We appreciate that and the ability to hop meetings, hop portals. It's very exciting. It's technology. We're going to wait for council members and members of the administration to come back on.
And if you guys don't mind, I'm going to be eating during the meeting because I have a rec commission meeting at 7 o'clock. So I needed to figure out some time for dinner.
No problem, Marcia. I'm going to turn it right over to you when we get started, and then you can turn it over to Maria and and enjoy whatever you're having for dinner.
My husband cooked it, so.
Got it.
I'm baking, so excuse me if I keep getting up.
What are you baking?
Don't forget.
Apple cobbler.
Oh, I made some the other day. We'll have to compare recipes.
What's your address?
Everyone?
All right, are we all back on? We got, I think I'm seeing everybody. Donna's on.
Melissa's on. Jahani's here.
Melissa's on. We're good. Okay. So we need to stream this live, right? And
we're working on that.
And record. Okay, very good. I'm just going to watch and wait to see all the signals.
And just as we're moving ahead, we want to limit this meeting, if we can possibly, to an hour.
I'm on that.
Okay. Only because I have another meeting at 7, so.
Anybody have an Instapot going? I've been seeing some great recipes, but I don't have one, so.
I have a menu ready for the Chinese restaurant.
Hey.
You win that one, Donna.
I'm so hungry for Chinese. We've been eating like everything in the fridge, finishing it up, and time for good old Chinese with a nice Riesling on the side.
I eat that on Christmas Eve, so.
Guys, just one second. Elizabeth's asking if she's in. She can hear us, but are we seeing her come through?
Let me take a look.
Linda will be able to get her in a second.
Okay, and we are now live on Facebook, so just reminding everybody that if you want to take a minute to share, I know some of us have been sharing that, and then we're going to get this started. Okay. Do we have our solicitor on? I see Jamal's joined us. Good evening, Jamal.
Elizabeth's in the process.
There she is. She popped through.
Good evening, everyone.
We thank everybody for their patience. Okay, Linda, ready?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Good evening, everybody. We're back. Thank you for your patience. Those of us that had to step out for a moment, we were hopping portals for an executive session called by our solicitor on some litigation. We are back and we're back to our agenda. I'm going to turn the agenda over to Marcia and let her run this finance review for the budget this evening.
Thank you very much, Lucine. And as we discussed earlier, we are going to be adding an item to the agenda and removing one. So we're going to start the meeting out with a report from the city auditor. We will not be reviewing the law department this evening. That will be scheduled for November 23rd. However, we will be reviewing the charter board and the ethics board. So I'm going to turn the meeting now over to Maria.
Thank you, everyone. Good evening. Tonight, I am fulfilling my responsibility as defining Article 5, Section 503B of the City of Vernon Home Rule Charter. I submit my non-binding recommendation to City Council for consideration. Linda, could you do me a favor and bring up the slides, please?
Mm-hmm. Trying to do that. Oh, there we go.
Thank you. for the 2021 proposed budget, for the 2021 general fund proposed budget, the administration is recommending the following: a general fund balance budget of 92 million. The 2021 proposed general fund budget is 1.7 million less than 2020 general fund budget, to use a fund balance transfer of 2.9 million, a 10% property tax increase, a salary increase of 2.5 across the board, two new full-time positions, four new part-time positions. My recommendation number one, the 2019 draft audit indicates a fund balance for capital project budget of 15.9 million, which include 1.5 million for a street paving fund. Most recent, on January 27, 2020, a transfer of 1.5 million was approved by City Council from the general fund balance to the street paving fund on the capital projects funds. And as of October 31, 2020, the liquid fuels account has a balance of 7.4 million. My recommendation is to use 1.5 million or part of that money that was transferred this year to the street paving fund could be reallocated to help reduce the proposed real estate property tax increase. The need for the increase in the street paving fund could be revisited after the funds from the liquid fuel account has been dropped down. And I say that because the liquid fuel account has 7.4 million, and that money cannot be used for anything else except for street paving, for bridges and stuff like that. So that money is not, the administration cannot allow that money to be used for anything else, just for that purpose. So that would be 1.5 million right there. My second recommendation number two, the Reading Water Authority and the Parking Authority are two components unit of the city finance. Due to the lease agreement with Rawa, the 2020 budget show a transfer of $10.4 million and $850,000 from the Reading Parking Authority. For the last 2 years, the administration has overstated the budget revenue from the Reading Parking Authority by $450,000. And for the 2021 budget, the administration is proposing only $400,000. I recommend a multi-year contract with the Reading Parking Authority, so this will allow the administration to budget more accurate for this revenue line item in the future. And the impact, I mean, we don't know until we had a contract in place with the Reading Parking Authority. Hope that can be solved soon. My recommendation number three, I review a couple of accounts in detail on the revenue side for this year trading forecast to the revenue collection, and I recommend the following changes in the following account. I would say increase 244,000 to per capita tax prior. By reviewing that line item, I realized that we had collected very good money on per capita tax in 2019 and also this year in 2020. Decrease the business privilege tax by $120,000. We're not collecting a lot of money for business privilege tax this year, and even last year we was on the budget for that item. Increase the business privilege license by $20,000. I think a better job can be done with business privilege license. The fee for business privilege license is $55. And if we take in consideration how many businesses the city has, I think that's the line item that we can, that maybe something can be done moving forward. For the cable franchise fees, I would say we should budget $50,000 less than what the administration is proposing, because by looking the data from the last two previous year, I know we're not going to receive $875,000. For the housing inspection, I would say increase the line item to $50,000 this year. The PMI department has not been able to do a lot of inspection due to COVID-19. And I don't know if next year, if they have them in power, maybe to catch it up and try to recoup some of the of that revenue for next year. $79,000 increase to health and safety inspection. That's the, for the safety and health for the health and safety inspection revenue. That's the any time that the city sell a property that is going to be only occupied, the city inspect that property and that money, that revenue going to that line item. So due to the that a lot of property has been sold this year, maybe something can be catched up for next year, for this year revenue to next year. Increase related to hard and loan benefit in the fire department. That line item, I see that that's money get transferred out of the SERF insurance, which is Fund 52, for reimbursement the hard and loan benefit. And I see that there is an increase in transferring more money every year, so I think we can increase that line item as well. For the prescription reimbursement, that's the money that the city receive. It's a credit that, like, not a credit, it's some revenue that the city received from CVS, and we're getting more than what we have been budgeting the last 2 years. And if the agreement with the Reading Parking Authority get executed before the final budget approval, maybe we can increase the line item from 400,000 to 600,000. So I would say we can increase that line item to $200,000 more. And I try to be conservative when I was looking those line items and not go to the stand, so that way we can have some cushion there in case something happens. So the total revenue adjustment in that line item would be $461,900. $460,900. So then my next recommendation number four, the administration is proposing 2.5% wage increase for both management and collective bargaining union represented employee. I would say that we should keep the same amount that was budgeted, the same percentage that was budgeted in 2020, which was 2%, due to the pandemic and everything that is going on this year. So the proposed wage increase should be placed, and also the proposed wage increase should be placed separately in our contingency fund until labor agreements are finalized. So this year, today, spending forecasting can be more reflected. So the physical impact by decreasing the salary increase to 2%, that we save about $180,000. The expenses, most of the expenses that we know are fixed. So the highest expenses on the general fund are salary and wages, pension, fringe benefit, operating expenses, and debt services. So there is not much that can be done about those expenses. The position ordinance is listing two new full-time positions and four part-time positions. The two new positions are in recycling and trash. The sustainability coordinator at a salary of $51,956, and the city clean coordinator at a salary of $60,000. There are other three positions: the sewer retail GIS system analyst as $36,400, so totaling $109,200 a year. The sewer retail part-time position is at a salary of $21,840. The proposed non-binding recommendation could result in additional saving of $2.1 million this year for 2020 budget. Also, by looking the calculation of the numbers on the real estate property tax, I think we had to take and review. I was reviewing those calculations. I think we should be looking at the property tax calculation by reviewing the city assessed valuation time the property tax mills. So I think there might be a little bit more revenue that can bring it in there. So but we had to take a look, and Jamara would like to talk to you about that, and maybe we can get together to see what can be done about that. This is my presentation for tonight. And also, but I would like to thank you, Mayor Eddie Moran, Managing Director Abraham Ramos, the Finance Director Jamar Kelly and his staff, and Department Directors, Division Manager and staff, and City Council members for their dedication and commitment to have a balanced budget for 2021. Although we are still facing many physical challenges, even with the pandemic and the SOR 47, let's hope that the decision taken via this budget process will not negatively impact the health, safety, and welfare of our citizen, business people, and employees. If you have any questions, I'm open for any question that you might have.
I would just say that from the administration side, we will review your report and provide an appropriate response. There are more than a few areas that just are quite very different than the way they were presented, and we'll follow up with that in writing.
Okay.
And Maria, you did provide us that report in writing through an email, so we all have a copy to be able to look at that and then look at the administration responses. And this is the way the process normally works, that mm-hmm. there's areas of agreement and disagreement, and to know that the budget is a fluid process, so that as we get down to all our discussions, we may have other information presented. But I thank you for your detailed work on this process.
Thank you.
Okay, do I see any questions from council at all at this point?
Just a comment. Maria, thank you so much. You know, we received that report. It was very nice to review that prior to the introduction this evening. And most of my questions that I've noted really will be then in response to the administration's review and analysis of what was presented. And I agree with Marcia, you know, the more involvement that we have, the more people who are, you know, scrutinizing and, you know, measuring the budget, the more appropriate it will be as we start to work towards the finality of what we really can do to present this fiscal responsibility. So thank you for that.
Thank you.
And as we're moving forward, I want to thank everyone here, because this is a very detailed and time-consuming process, the way that we've all been diligent about how we've approached this. I really appreciate that. So tonight we have two budgets. I'm going to turn it over to Jamar and get us to the right tabs.
Thank you, Councilor Goodman-Henschitz. So tonight we are on tab 15. And for the internet PDF viewers, that's going to be page 38 of 66. And sorry, I need to minimize all these faces on my screen. There we go. Okay. If you scroll to the bottom of the Excel spreadsheet, we are on row 1,133, the Board of Ethics, starting with the Charter Board. In 2021, we have the Charter Board budgeted at $50,000. That is an increase of 50% over the previous year. It was $25,000 in 2020. We are maintaining the line item for the Animal Control Board at $5,000. There will be no activity for the Charter Review Commission. The Environmental Advisory Council is maintaining their $10,000 allocation from 2020. And then we are maintaining the Board of Ethics at $20,000 for 2021, the same as it was in 2020, for a total of $85,000 budgeted for the Board of Ethics, Charter Board, Animal Control Board, and Environmental Advisory Council combined. There are no personnel costs associated with these boards. They're directly, I should say, our deputy city clerk quite ably assists all of those boards with support internally. Do we have any questions from members of council on the ethics board and charter board, animal control, and environmental advisory council as presented? Councilor Salmon.
Jamar, if you could just remind me of the need to increase, so 1137, Board of Ethics, 2019 was 12,500, 2020, 20, and we're sticking with 20 for 21. Go ahead.
So if there were a desire to impose the 15% here, I would say there is room to do so. So far in 2020, there have only been about $3,800 in charges for the ethics board. So their level of activity year over year is not such that it needs to maintain 20,000. If there were any desire to make a reduction, that would be possible.
Thanks. I'd like to hear from the Board of Ethics as to, you know, justification really kind of their expenditures and, you know, their overall opinion. Because certainly we're looking at a time where we really need to scrutinize the areas where we can. We very much appreciate the work and the role that all of these boards and commissions played, you know, to serve our city.
If I could offer unsolicited, I think it is very good that we have an ethics board here at the city. We recently had a call on the buying refinancing, and it was a good chink in our armor to be able to say that we have an ethics board with enforcement authority here at the city. So we definitely want to maintain some appropriate level of funding there. We just want to make sure it's appropriate.
Jamar, just looking at the line items too, and serving as the council representative on the Environmental Advisory Council, I have some idea.
Can I just stop my timer?
Yeah, sure. We all want the product that he's baking here.
I thought the building was on fire.
No.
I put some in my house.
Yeah, we're trying to avoid that.
Is it done yet?
Yes, it's done.
Okay. My question is with the Environmental Advisory Board. Could you explain the $10,000 allocation, even though that's not been funded before, what that is targeted for?
So that board is a new rig that I don't know that the council is new. I believe the funding request and 2019 was new, and if you give me just a couple of seconds, I can pull up the activity.
And Michelle, Shelley says she will be able to answer that.
Oh, Shelley, please.
So the Environmental Advisory Council is looking to do some signage projects around town. That would identify some green infrastructure, so things like green roofs, riparian buffers, rain gardens, gray water facilities that use gray water. So that's where they plan to spend that $10,000, and they are working towards that now. They did have $10,000 in 2020, and they will probably not spend that because they're not, COVID put some delays on this project. So they're asking for that to be rolled into and be sustained in 2021.
Thank you very much, Shirley.
So just to clarify, we can't roll it, but we can fund it.
No, yeah, but that the budgeted amount would remain the same.
Okay. So in 2019 is where the zero was, 2020 was the 10,000. And I really respect sitting on that board with Lucene. I really respect the work that they are doing, and it fits in with the administration's initiative for clean cities, the sustainability. So that's good.
Yeah, I agree, Marcia. Thank you. You know, I think it aligns too with our Writing for 100 legislation and the climate action plan that, you know, we're working towards. So I'm happy to see them funded and moving forward in the work they're doing.
If I could, Shelley, can we just make sure that that signage is coordinated properly with the communications coordinator and the Downtown Plus effort as well?
Yeah, we are already working with Christian. And I'm also working with zoning and planning because of the sign installation and issues.
Awesome. Yeah, just want to make sure we're all rowing in the same direction there. I turn it back over to Councilor Goodman Henschitz.
Okay, and this is the budgets we have presented for this evening. So unless I have any other questions budgetarily from council, we can be closing the meeting.
Did you want to hear Shane McFarland, who's the chair of the charter board, is on the call? Would you like to hear his perspective on the budget request?
Yeah. Usually it should come up. Yeah, that would be fine. I was just thinking it should probably come under public comment, but that's fine.
Shane?
Yes, thank you very much for having me on. I just want to make a quick comment. First, again, thank you so much for having me on today. And if it looks weird that I'm looking at one screen and not looking at the camera. Yeah, I'm using a double screen, split screen, so I'm looking all over the place. Nonetheless, thank you very much for understanding the need for increased funding for the charter board. There is somewhat of I wouldn't say a misconception, but just a muted communication with the charter board and I'm talking historically, there has been, you know, a muted communication with the board, the administration, and council. I do as the new chair, I do hope going forward we can collaborate on many things that we have in the pipeline. I do hope we'll be able to increase our communication, especially as it relates to our education role. That is something that I'm very passionate about. I do feel that as a board, we haven't been doing much to educate not only the public but our administration. So I think if we can do a lot more in that regard, then we'd be spending a lot less going forward. With that said, I do want to say that with our ongoing issues that are in front of the courts, I can't comment specifically about those issues, but if we cease to exhaust our legal or warranted legal options, then we set a rather bad precedent for future cases, which could be somewhat damaging to the board. But then again, we are cognizant of the fact that pursuing these legal options means we're also putting somewhat undue burden on the city's financial status. So I just wanted to say that so everyone is aware that we are thinking about the city's finances while we make these tough decisions also.
Well, thank you very much, Shane. I think it's important to hear that. Okay. And normally we have presentations from the boards, authorities, and commissions. I'm going to ask Shelley, when is the charter board next scheduled for a presentation?
Unfortunately, I'm at home and not at my desk. I have that schedule in the office, but I can absolutely check that and send. It won't be until next week, but I will be able to send that out to everyone and then start, like I said before, Last night you questioned the delay in the board's authorities and commissions presentations, and that is an ongoing schedule that I work on consistently. So they are coming up. It's just that it's been a few in a row that I was unable to. Generally, it's a scheduling conflict with whichever board whose turn it is.
And just to explain to you, Shane, that means that you as the chair of the board will be able to present at a public meeting. And we always like to be able to hear that way. So I thank you for coming in this evening. Do any other council members have any questions for Shane? I'm looking around my screen. Okay, seeing none, thank you very much.
All right, thank you guys for having me.
Okay, and is there anything else that we need for tonight's meeting before we adjourn? Okay, seeing none, it's time to leave, and I'll be heading out to my next meeting in another hour, so take care.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, everybody. Thank you. Ooh. Linda.
Yeah.
Are there technically public comment periods during budget hearings?
No, we don't do public comment at working sessions, only at regular meetings.
Yeah, I didn't. So, I mean, the circumstance of, you know, letting him speak, fine. But that's kind of also, you know, with certain areas like this that are funded with, let's say, BCTV or the ethics board or whatever, you know, when do they have the opportunity to kind of, you know, vocalize and justify, I guess, right? Like,
invite them in, like Bronwyn was in last night for the library.
So who invites them?
I do.
You do? Okay. All right. You know, because I think, like, I don't ever want to recommend cutting, you know, a budget for, you know, like, the ethics board, but, you know, if that's an area where they're not utilized.
Pardon the interruption, but BCTV is still connected on here, just so you know.
Oh, very good. Thanks, Ken.
I apologize. Linda, you're good. I'm going to jump out.
Yeah, the stream's off.
Yeah, when the attendees.
Zoom. Yeah, that's okay.
Okay.
They'll know to cut.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's okay. So, I'll follow up with you on that. Just because I do want to give opportunity for, you know, people to be able to vocalize, especially the chairs of our boards and authorities and commissions.
Yeah, well, we can't get them all in, not for budget.
No, I know, but. You know, but they're probably kind of waiting in the wings to be like, oh, you know, I hope, you know, let's see what happens. So, you know, again, if it comes in front of council with areas where possibly we could, you know, have reductions, and I don't know if, you know, we were proposed internally to the administration to try to do 15% to 20% reductions. I don't know that that went out to any of our boards, authorities, and commissions. So. Just throwing out something that occurred to me this evening when we had that comment.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. Well, thank you. Sorry to keep you on longer than needed.
That's okay.
All right. Have a good night.
All right. Adios.
Bye.
Bye, Ken.
Hold the leg out. Thank you.
Okay.